Hey folks, today we're getting into color work. Howdy all, in today's more theoretical video, we're gonna be taking a look at how to take advantage of Zoner Photo Studio's tone curve to improve and raise the level of your color work and playing around with your photograph's colors. And because it's all related, we're also gonna be talking about split toning. Let's go take a look. Both tools are based on the same concept, which means adding colors to a photo based on exposure. And we can also adjust exposure in the tone curve, classically using the red, green, blue or Luma settings. But we'll talk about that another time. Today we'll focus on using the tone curve and split toning for color correction. Now you're probably wondering why on earth am I using these tools in particular to do my color correction when I already have color shift as well as shift primary colors for that. Well, this is best explained by examining the differences between these functions themselves. Color shift and shift primary colors select a specific color and change its hue, saturation, and luminance only in the areas where that color is found. On the other hand, the tone curve and split toning control exposure and add the color that we choose to certain light or dark areas of the photo. And this allows us to control the color of certain areas of the photo, such as only the light areas, even if they have the same color as the darker areas. And that's what I would like you guys to understand and what I want to show in this video in particular, how to fine tune your photo's colors by exposure and not by color. Before we get into specific examples, it's important to note that while it's not required, color correction is best done on a monitor that's been properly calibrated, or you're not gonna get the best that you can out of the software. If you're unsure about your monitor's color settings, then our histogram can really help with that. Now, the histogram is a very useful tool, and if it's something that you're interested in learning more about, we may do a future video on that based on the amount of comments we receive below, so please let us know. Now, back to our regular scheduled programming. All right, let's take a look at a simple example. Say I want to add some green to the lights of this photo using the tone curve. I have a choice of red, green, or blue, or RGB as everyone knows it. Remember that because we'll go back to that later in this video. Now let's select a green and locate the lights in the tone curve. Now to help, let's use the line segment here, which is going to show the darkest part of the exposure towards the bottom and the lightest part at the top right. Now let's add a point to the top and pull it up. You can see that the green has been added evenly to all of the lighter areas of the photo. You might have also noticed that the curve has been bent so that the green has also gotten into the darker and more mid-range parts of the exposure. And let's get rid of this by adding another point and then lowering the green in these areas. And this process works similarly to split toning. Let's reset the tone curve settings just to demonstrate the same thing using split toning. While we can't focus on very specific exposure with split toning, we do have a much more varied color palette, which we can add to the photo. We can easily add green. And we do that in the lights color wheel. Now let's move this dot toward green. And that's it. Okay, but what if I have too much of one color and I want to take it away? Again, a bit of theory comes in handy to understand why and how these tools work. It's no coincidence that the tone curve has a combination of red, green, and blue, or RGB, as we mentioned earlier. These are the primary colors that we can mix to create any other color on the color spectrum. In the color world, there are two main types of color mixing, the additive model, or RGB, and the subtractive model, or CMYK. The difference between these two models is whether light creates color, additive model, or reflected light creates color, subtractive model. And that's why RGB is mainly used for TVs and monitors, and why CMYK is used for printed designs. Just like RGB stands for the names of the primary colors, CMYK is no different, and that's cyan, magenta, yellow, and K, which stands for black. And that's created by combining three of the previous colors. Now, combining RGB is gonna be all of the colors together, and that's gonna create our regular white light, just like we know it from the sun. The most important thing to understand is that CMYK colors are actually opposites to RGB. Red and cyan are opposites, just like green and purple, and yellow and blue. All right, this finally brings us to how we can use the tone curve or split toning, which add color to subtract a color from a photo. Now we use these colors to add the color's opposite or complementary color, which eliminates the color itself. Now let's demonstrate it using an example. Let's see how we can use the tone curve in the lights to subtract blue. The easiest thing to do now is to select blue and subtract it from the lights. The opposite color, yellow, is now added. It's not always so simple, so I want to show you how it works if I want to add a color to subtract another color. We've got the same photo here, but it's edited in a way that we have too much purple here in the lights. And we don't have purple available to me, but we know that the opposite color to purple is green. So let's select green and increase it in the lights. Here, notice how the color has balanced out nicely. Let's undo the changes and now demonstrate how to use the same thing using split toning. The placement of our colors in our color wheel here isn't just random. Opposite colors are located directly opposite one another. So if we want to remove purple from the lights, we've got to find it in the wheel and move the dot in the opposite direction, or in this case, towards green. And after fine-tuning the purple hues, we've removed them completely. Now that we've explained how and why everything works, let's try fine-tuning the colors in a photo that have extremely poor color balance. Okay, at first glance, we can see that the photo is overly green in the lights and purple in the shadows. So when we start off with the lights and split toning, we're gonna add the opposite color of green, which is purple, to the lights. And right away, we can see that the green has beautifully turned to white. And once we're done with the lights, let's start with the shadows. We want to subtract the purple from the shadows and add green. And so we're gonna focus on this shadow here, which is around the delete key. And again, we can see that a purple tint is going away from the shadow. When we're done tweaking the colors, we can see that there is green in the darkest and almost black parts of the shadows, which we don't want. So let's go back to the tone curve and let's add a point here just to isolate darkest parts. Then let's move the button point to subtract green. To tweak the colors even more, let's add another point between these two and add a little bit of green so that it doesn't blend into the part of the shadow where there's too much purple. And there you go. Now this is what the photo looked like before and now after our color correction. Much better, don't you think? That's it in this video. I hope you liked it. Give us a thumbs up, let us know what you think below, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care and see you later.